Hi everyone, my name is Denise. I'm a health freedom activist in the state of California, and I'm co-founder of Freedom Angels.
Hi guys, I'm Heidi. I am a co-founder of Freedom Angels, and I live in the San Francisco Bay Area.
Hi, I'm Tara, co-founder of Freedom Angels in the Northern Sierra Nevada Mountains of California.
Thank you for joining us every day, Monday through Friday. We do a live at 5 discussing freedom and liberty. You can find us on our YouTube channel, Freedom Angels, our Facebook page, Freedom Angels Foundation, as well as our IG page. Now, today we're going to be talking about a multitude of different things, but right now the elephant in the room is a vaccine that is now coming out that Tara, you are going to talk about.
Yes. There's like 5 or 6 different vaccines that are in trial right now. And just an important point on them, 2 of them, but one by Moderna and one by Johnson & Johnson, both have aborted fetal cell lines in them that they're being used to develop them. So that's a really important point. We could talk about that after, but what we're going to discuss right now is Inova's vaccine. They have a totally different delivery system. Instead of syringe, they're going to use an injection machine called, was it Selectra? And it has 3 needles, and 1 needle is used to inject the DNA vaccine, and then the other 2 provide an electrical stimulus to the cell membranes that allows the material, the DNA material, to be forced in at 1,000 times the rate than something would normally be able to get into a cell membrane. Cell wall. So again, that's Heidi. You mentioned that's been used before in military vaccines, which I actually didn't know. But either way, you can tell this is a whole nother level. I mean, we've talked before about that. We also know that the vaccine transmission systems are going to be developed in different ways, where they're even going to have, you know, nanotech involved. Like high-level nanotech involved. And this is just another example of where we're going, the steps along the line to that.
Yeah, absolutely. And why is nobody talking about, you know, these stem cells that are going to be injected through those vaccines? What do foreign stem cells do to our body? They cause tumor growth, exponential tumor growth. It's one thing to get your own stem cells put back into you to heal your body. It's a whole nother thing when you mess around with foreign stem cells. So that's why this aborted fetal cells inside vaccines, this is a humongous deal, guys. This isn't just about a pro-life, pro-choice thing. This is about pro-tumor, anti-tumor. So which are you guys picking, guys? You gotta think through, think past what they're selling you. They're selling you some strong Kool-Aid, folks.
Yeah, don't be pro-tumor.
Exactly. We need to claim that back.
It's really well put. I love it.
It's pro-tumor. And the other one that we got to reclaim right now too is we're all in house arrest. They put us all on house arrest. My sister told me that the other day. She's like, they locked us down and our whole nation is on house arrest. And I was like, I never thought of it that way. Again, we got to reframe it for what this is. Stop using hearts or stay at home hearts.
The profile pictures of stay home. Please be on house arrest, even though you did nothing wrong. Just like, did you guys see the video of the woman who she went through the drive-through to get tested? She wasn't sick, but she had some kind of cough going on. Well, she's going for her run, and she's tracked by the police department. They know who she is. They've checked her Facebook. They already said you're positive, and she's like, "No, I'm not. I've quarantined." And they physically arrest, they put her in handcuffs and they arrest her. I mean, this isn't just about they catch you on the street. They are physically tracking you. When you go through these drive-throughs and you give them your ID and you give them your information, guess what? That's going into their database. This is that digital certificate startup that we were talking about. And now if you are, you know, your phone's being tracked, if you're out there walking your dog or taking a run, you're gonna get arrested for not doing absolutely anything.
Or how about we didn't get to do the full talk yesterday. We discussed the 22 people in San Diego County who were ticketed with $1,000 tickets for sitting on the beach in family units or in cars watching the sunset at the beach. Now, under the worst economic conditions of all times, the county decided to issue people $1,000 tickets for that. That's just, I mean, again, or where we talked about the one, the picture you showed, Denise, where the couple sitting next to each other in New York, and a police officer tells them, you have to sit 6 feet apart. And they're like, we're married, we live together. And they said, I'm gonna arrest you if you don't stand 6 feet apart. So this is where it shows you at the county, state, community level, it really does matter what position is being taken. So Denise, wanna talk about like the way that you can fight this, like where we have sheriffs and police departments that are fighting these kinds of unjust and overreach laws that are overreaching?
You are right, because so many people are saying, what are we gonna do? We're gonna stand up to the federal government. We're gonna do this. Absolutely not. We're gonna start locally. Locally is absolutely the most important. Like what we saw in Riverside, where the orders went out, you have to wear a mask when you go to the grocery stores, you have to wear a mask when you go outside. And the sheriff is saying, no, we are not going to do this. We are going, it's education. Yep. That is their position. And this has been the position for many sheriffs across the states. It is about education. It is not about ticketing. So I would like to see, when this is all said and done, what our courts are going to look like, because I hope these people fight these tickets. What a waste of money in a time when we are already in an economic crash. We are having police officers ticketing and arresting people who are just outside while the courts are releasing prisoners from jail because they're scared that it's overcrowded and they're going to get a virus. So where is this full circle going to happen? And I really, really hope these courts are going to be inundated by people who do get ticketed. But this is where you start. You start locally. Local sheriff should be your absolutely first phone call. What is your position? A lot of people want this big template on what to say, but that's what you say. What is your position? Are you protecting the Constitution and my right to be outside, or are you siding with these unconstitutional policies because they're not laws? How are you getting arrested over an unjust policy is beyond me.
Mm-hmm. Well, you hit it on the nail on the head though when you brought up the court systems. What does due process look like under martial law, under emergency orders? And that's right now, there is no due process. It's been suspended. And so how do you handle these things when the courts are closed, when, you know, the process is shut down? I mean, even only the most egregious crimes domestic violence and such are being brought into the court system. Well, it's pretty egregious what's going on against, you know, humanity with regards to constitutional rights, yet there's no process to handle it. So how do we do that? How do we deal with this overreach and the suspension of informed consent? I mean, of due process.
Lots of lawyers, I hope. I mean, I'm waiting for these lawyers to come out, and a few have come out and said, you know, I'm taking these cases pro bono. But we need to be asking these officers, when you, and this is important, to record every interaction that you have with a police officer when they're stopping you for this stuff. So we're in the middle of a pandemic. We're in the middle of an economic crash. I'm not working. I'm not even allowed to be outside, but yet you're fining me $1,000 on top of all the other things that I have to pay, my rent, my food, take care of my family. So what exactly is the position of this police department? And a lot of times they're saying, I'm just doing my job. Well, it's time for them to step out of line and stop just doing their job and start working with these sheriff's offices and saying, no, we're not going to do this. This is unconstitutional. And I'm hoping to see more attorneys stepping out and saying, whoa, we need to start fighting back on this.
Yeah, and more sheriffs too. We know there's one in Maine. You talked about the one in Riverside County. I personally know one in Colorado Springs right now, a sheriff who is saying absolutely not, under no circumstances are we asking for people's papers and right to travel. They're like, this is way stepped over the line. That's not what I swore an oath to do.
And this is the thing, everything is so new. This is all new ground. We have never encountered something like this. And San Joaquin County Sheriff has said it. Stanislaus County Sheriff has said it. everybody is treading on very unclear waters right now. So why not err on the side of caution and actually protect the Constitution and stay with that education part instead of treading on uncharted waters and then possibly getting yourself in the middle of a big heap of a mess once we're out of this whole lockdown thing? I mean, I hope these people get hit hard, especially that dad who was arrested for playing softball.
Oh, I know. And how is this all being allowed? The fear that people have bought into. And this is what we want to talk more about, the snitching that's going on. Like how the LA mayor said, you know, what was the exact quote? I forgot. It's basically
get rewarded.
Yes, snitches get rewarded. And good job for keeping everybody safe, for snitching on your neighbor. That is harkens back to Nazi Germany. I mean, straight up. And we've learned those lessons in history. But it's that fear that allows, you know, that if people think that is the way to go, and, you know, and you got to push back on that. And that's where these sheriffs and these community members can really have an impact on this. But also, you know, social media is important to keep the tone out there that we won't tolerate that. And also that, you know, we want access to therapeutics. Those are important to have those things running in social media, because people are basically stuck in front of their screens now all day. But then right. At the local level also.
They're so in fear of what's going on right now. They feel that if they get this virus, they're going to die. This is their fear, right? They don't feel there's any therapeutics out there that's going to help. There's no medication that's out there that's going to help. And this is lack of leadership in each state. Instead of talking about ventilators and body bags and ships that are going to hold 20,000 people, why don't our leaders talk about the proven therapeutics that are out there that are working, instead of trying to hold off until an untested vaccine comes on the market? That these are the things that our leaders need to start talking about in order to calm the fear that these people have. But we already know that's not going to happen. They want the vaccine out. They want people to live in fear, because then they're going to comply.
And far more than just the vaccine. I mean, the surveillance and, you know, antibody testing, tracing and testing, that basically tracking. But the important thing to note is that it's very, they've politicized the health and well-being of humanity. And I mean, remember we talked here about how Newsom a couple week and a half ago said, ventilators are the only treatment that we know works. No, not even close. And this is really scary, because we know, so we've been talking to some doctors too and getting the updates on what really is the best pathway forward. And we also, you know, have confirmed that every hospital has their own COVID-19 protocol. So this is really important. I want to kind of talk about this really quick, just so that we say it out there, so that people know this. You know, every single hospital has a different protocol, and they're not all using the most effective and up to date. We heard UC Irvine was testing anti-HIV drugs, and that is not what's showing effective. But if your family member's in there, you better be trying to advocate as hard as you can for the most effective treatment. And so really, no matter what hospital, if someone you know ends up in a hospital, it's really important to find out what is the protocol. You've heard talk now that the it's going away from the thought that you go on ventilators right away. Thank God they're finally getting away from that, because what they've found is that it's really more an issue of oxygen saturation. That what's happening is that iron ions are being removed from, your red blood cells, and then your red blood cells can't transport oxygen. So the short end of the story is you want to have hydroxychloroquine, Z-Pax, and zinc sulfate, IV vitamin C's, and proper DNA early on, like at the doctor's office, like not even at the hospital, not even at the ER, but at the doctor's office. And then
that is strange. I don't know why, Tara, you got cut off. I'm trying to unmute you and you're muted and I can't unmute you. That is so weird. They're obviously messing with our... Yeah, you got muted. So the last of that got cut off. And we know there's like major censorship going on. We only have 15 more minutes. Did you want to finish your statement there? It was like the last minute that got cut off.
Yeah, really quick, I will. So basically, I'm just got my thing got weird too. Hang on. Shoot. Uh-oh.
Well,
you go, Heidi. I literally my phone. Hang on.
I know they're doing strange, crazy things to us, but we were talking about.
Okay,
go ahead.
Okay, so basically, can you hear me good enough?
Yep, I can hear you.
So basically, oh my God.
Here, I'm going to just jump in real fast because I want to make sure we get this in. It ties in with the hydroxychloroquine. And it also goes more into global events that are happening right now. I think it's really important that everybody is paying attention to the fact that right now, with the UN, in the Human Rights Council, China was just issued a seat on that council. And that should be the biggest wake-up call to any American from day one from the very beginning of this crisis. Who was praised? China was praised. And again, this is not a racist thing. We're talking about the Chinese Communist Party. That's who we're talking about, the Communist Party, not the actual individual Chinese. They're beautiful people, as Trump says and other people say. We are talking about the Chinese Communist Party. They have the most egregious human rights violations ever. And now the UN is giving them a seat on the Human Rights Council. Guys, where have we gone in this world? Where have we gone?
Yeah, that's like literally straight up insane.
Mm-hmm.
Straight up insane. I do want to, I don't want to downplay that because that's like just mind-blowing and crazy. But I do want to bring that out really quick that if, honestly, people like Governor Newsom, Governor Cuomo, Governor Murphy, all of those governors that have blocked the use of hydroxychloroquine and other effective treatments early on and at the places where they're most efficacious, you know, those are what they should be brought to war tribunals on for crimes against humanity. Because literally, that is the place that not only has the fear generated from, but that's where the injury has happened. That's where, you know, the damage has heard. People have a right to try. They have a right to access to this, and they've literally blocked it. So basically, to recap really quick, what they're finding right now is that you want to, you know, have high oxygen. You want to saturate with oxygen if you're in the, this is in the hospital. Saturate with oxygen. Hold off on intubation until as the very last minute, even if oxygen stat, blood stat levels drop to 70 or 80, as long as the person's able to breathe and isn't complaining that they can't breathe, you just keep flooding them with oxygen and hold off on intubation as long as possible. And when you do intubate, lowest pressure as possible, you consider they're doing blood transfusions now, which has its own issues, but it is what's allowing us to flood in red blood cells that are healthy so that they can carry oxygen. Also, be very careful about the amount of IV fluids that are being used because they build up fluids in the lungs and that's what leads to flooding of the lungs and ARDS. Also, rotating the patient so that they can move the fluid in their lungs. Definitely twice daily, 2,000 milligram or 2,000, two times a day of IV vitamin C, twice a day of hydrochloroquine, I think at 400 levels, and zinc as well. And then the last thing besides Z-Pak, heard that they're finding that it really helps to have a higher, a stronger antibiotic like cefepime. These are for the critical care at the end. What all these, you know, governors and politicians should be, you know, put on trial for is how they're blocking the early stage care and therapeutics that could keep people from getting into that situation.
Yeah, absolutely. I wanted to bring up the fact too that I saw an article come up recently in the last week that Israel was sending the U.S. millions and millions of the hydrochloroquine tablets, pills, specifically as a gift too, not alone, a gift. So, you know, people can take that as they may, but this is meaning there are people coming in that want to help. And again, it's being politicized, it's being blocked. It is well known Trump is the most pro-Israel president that we have had in a very, very long time. So again, is this another reason why the governors are politicizing it? Newsom and Cuomo and Murphy and, you know, the Lamonts, like, we don't know exactly what it is, but it sure seems like it could be, wouldn't you think?
Mm-hmm. Makes sense to me. And let's talk about a little about what Trump did with the WHO, World Health Organization. What he said.
He said he was going to defund them. That's what he said yesterday, which was amazing. Yeah. He said they've obviously done something. They've skewed the numbers. They've messed up. Like, they made some catastrophic errors. So why are we funding them? Just like, again, Trump has been one of the first presidents that is also defunding Planned Parenthood. And that's why so many people on the left don't like him. But again, guys, this Planned Parenthood, it comes back to the stem cells and what's being used in the pharmaceuticals and in the vaccines. Again, are we pro-tumor or not, guys? Because that's how we need to start rephrasing this. So again, I just think this is another way that this is being politicized of why the attack against Trump by the progressive side. Again, we don't need to get into he said, she said, but we're just trying to figure out, like, what's the bigger agenda at play here?
It's about time somebody starts looking into this World Health Organization funding. You know, they constantly cook the numbers, giving us false information. When the borders were, when Trump was trying to close the borders, there was an issue with that. And then what happened? We started bringing people in from a sick country to get treatment in the United States on planes, exposing other people. It was a big snowball effect. So hopefully not only with just this coronavirus, but now we're going to see all of the things, the mishandlings of vaccines and outbreaks and epidemics and all these things that we have been sold to in fear. It's about time that he starts talking about this. You know, I know he was real. He's always talked about the pharmaceutical companies and about their, you know, their profits. And it really is. It's profits over people right now. We are seeing that with very cheap medication that we already have versus a you know, vaccine that's going to come out solely for profit. We've already seen if enough people, and this is the thing, they want to do antibody testing on people. How the heck are we going to do that when we haven't even been exposed to this virus? We are told to stay inside. And then Fauci, oh, we can't have enough, too many people getting herd immunity. This is how real herd immunity works. You have enough people getting sick, building antibodies, but they don't want that to happen. They want you inside your house so that vaccine can hit and then the tracking begins.
Yeah, and I saw an article.
And therapeutic.
I saw an article come out today about the Bay Area that there's already a company called Premier Biotech, and the technicians are going to use a finger prick to draw blood for the test, and it can tell within minutes if a person developed antibodies for COVID. So guys, we talked about these health safety checkpoints to where you're able to get back into society. Yeah. So is that what we're going to have to do to show up at our job, to show up at our school, to drive down a certain freeway, to get into
leave your state. You know, I have family out of state. I want to go
visit.
That's
what they're saying.
Yeah. And in order to go into their state, I'm going to have to give them my DNA in order to pass through. Mm-hmm. This is show me your papers, high tech, 2020 style.
Some type of risk.
Right.
Yeah. So this is all about safety and risk.
Yeah.
Well, thank God at least Bill Gates and Fauci and, you know, World Health Organization and so many others, the agenda is being, you know, their agenda is becoming much more transparent. And you can see who's lining up with who. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's very clear. You can see Newsom lining up with Gates and Fauci, and you can see Cuomo and Newsom and Murphy and Lamont. You can see all of them lining up on one side against, you know, taking a certain position. So they're, you know, the tiger has revealed their stripes.
Absolutely.
And, you know, yep.
They're setting the framework for the entire country. So this isn't just the California, New York, New Jersey thing. These are the states that get tested to see if people are going to comply and if they're going to say, okay, it's for the humanity, it's for the greater good, I'm going to do it. Don't think for a second that your state is going to be safe unless you have a really great governor who is standing by their oath, the Constitution, but that's very slim pickings now.
Yeah. Absolutely. And speaking of slim pickings, the other headline news today was that Bernie Sanders, whatever his name is, he dropped out of the race.
Yeah.
So now
poor Bernie, second time.
I know the Dems, what's happening to them, but I have to say, don't just hold on like, oh, this is good or bad or whatever. The thing that struck me the most about him dropping out is that he says he's going to still stay in so that he gets his delegates and he's able, meaning for the convention's sake, he's out of the race. Biden is who's going to get it. But the point is so that he can still carry parts of his platform. And I think this is very important that Americans don't understand when there's multiple people that go for the nomination, there's multiple reasons that they're up there. It's not all that they truly think they're going to be president. It's to float agendas. It's to test the American population on what type of agendas they're going to be willing to accept, just like Andrew Yang floated universal basic income. Well, Bernie is all about universal everything socialism right here on a platter. So don't think that just because he's out, mm-hmm. that his philosophies and policies aren't going to be tried to be ushered in the back.
The American people have accepted socialism. You know, they've already accepted waiting
in
line
at
the store.
Are. Yeah, we're in it.
I mean, it was pretty easy for that to happen. You're waiting in line for your turn to get something to eat. And then there's those rows blocked off. You can't get this, but you can get this. And then they raise the prices of these products for no reason, because we know, I mean, I've seen dairy farms saying, it's not us. We're being told to release our product. So I just paid $5 for a dozen eggs when normally it's like $2.99 or $2 at Safeway. I mean, we are in socialism. We are in Bernie's dream right now. So it wasn't very hard for the American people to accept such an agenda.
No, that's absolutely true. They're just crediting.
Well, and we're at the point.
I was just saying they're crediting.
Well, and once you single-handedly,
they're crediting Bernie with single-handedly moving our country all the way to the left into socialism. Go ahead, Tara.
And we can credit Bill Gates too.
Yes.
And Fauci.
Why is he here?
Yeah, no,
seriously.
I was just,
why is he here?
Right. I know. Get out of here, Bill Gates. Go home. Sit the F down, right?
Really? I mean, there's really no point when we're always being told, you're not a doctor, you can't say anything. Well, neither is Bill Gates. Why is he the one who's gonna map out what the whole world's gonna look like?
Yeah. Forget that. I know. Well, and you know, like we were saying, is now what are people gonna do? You complied altruistically and out of fear, and now everyone's so stuck economically that they're going to feel they have to do the antibody testing and the contact tracing, which is high-tech surveillance, full-on surveillance, to, you know, enter back into society so they can protect their families and their, you know, their wife.
Yep.
It's like, it's again, they have people, it was crafted to basically put people in a situation where they felt they had no choice but to accept this.
That's what it's going to turn out to be. No choice. I mean, you have to eat, you have to pay your bills, you have to pay your rent, and there's no other choice if you want to re-enter society.
Yeah, exactly. I want to let you know we're hitting right up on the 30-minute mark. I just want to say briefly, real fast, this is Passover today, so happy Passover to everybody that is celebrating Passover. For Jews specifically, this is a big deal. For the first time in Israel's history, since the first Passover back in Egypt, all Jews in Israel are on house arrest. for the first time ever. So this is kind of a big, this is a big deal, guys, but happy Passover to everybody who celebrates.
Yeah. Yes. Hopefully some people to get together on Easter, some churches get together and they celebrate what's going on right now instead of being so scared and allowing the government to take that right away from them. So I know we keep this at 30 minutes.
And some more active resistance.
Yes, please.
And hi, Denise, talk about the really quick about YouTube, because this is how we're going to need to, you know, try and get over onto YouTube if we get enough subscribers.
So we, as you guys know, we do a live at 5 on Facebook every day. Facebook has stopped our ability to do that, and Zoom has also stopped our ability to stream live. So we do need 1,000 subscribers so we can have an interactive live on YouTube. Please hit the little bell button and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to bring you information live. And if you want to find us on Facebook, we are under Freedom Angels Foundation, as well as Instagram and Twitter. Thank you guys for listening to our Live at 5. We'll be back tomorrow again and talking about liberty and freedom.
All right. Bye.
All right. Bye, guys.
Bye.